Legend FM Breakfast with Alex and Victoria. Good morning.
Alrighty then, our Legend FM Local Love campaign, basically where we talk to Fijians who are doing innovative stuff, especially in the wake of this second wave of COVID-19. And this morning we are so happy. We are thrilled and privileged to be speaking with Meli Tungota. Meli, morning.
Yandra, I'm going pink with I'm a bit nervous the way you introduced me, man.
Meli, first of all, thank you so much for joining us this morning, mm-hmm. and we are not going to waste any time getting straight into it.
Okay, so Meli, first question, what is Solimbula?
So Solimbula is an animated short film that I'm trying to get made here in Fiji, and I'm sort of putting together a crew consisting of all local gangs who will be working with me to create this animated short film that's set in an alternate reality CG.
Meli, so some might ask, why do a project like this in the midst of a pandemic? Is art essential? What do you say to that?
The first thing that all of us did that when we went to our first lockdown last year, the first thing that we all did was we turned to music, we turned to films, we turned to TV shows. You know, we turn to all these artistic things to keep us sane, so to speak. And that's the thing that art does. It helps us understand the world in a different way, or it helps us keeps us at ease. And so that's why I think art is definitely important in these pandemic times. The second thing is that I didn't really plan for this to happen in the second wave. Or the first wave. It was sometime last year when I was sort of putting together the first building blocks of trying to get this made, and then I said, okay, I'll just wait it out a bit, and maybe by this time, you know, next year, the pandemic will be over. Boy, how little we all knew. So it just goes to show you can't plan for these things. You just have to do it, whether you like it or not, and come what may, so to speak. You know.
Okay, cool. Meli, just introduce us to the team working on the project, please.
Sure. So we have a bunch of cool guys working on this project, and I'm very happy to say that they're all local gang, which just goes to show that there's a wealth of talent here in Fiji that remains untapped when it comes to film production. So for me, I'm the writer and the director of the short film, but I'll also be animating the short film. Doing the art, drawing all the people, doing all the art on screen is Tui Lendua. He's a pretty great artist on his own. And then to create the music production is none other than Inoke Nox, the Koloni singer.
Nice.
He's been doing, funny enough, I didn't even know this, but he's been doing music soundtracks for TVs and TV shows and films. He did He worked on the intro for Survivor Fiji, so that's him there.
Mm.
And then I have a buddy of mine, Michael John Light, who's working on the Ndrua features prominently in this animated short film. That's a double hull kunu. And then we also have Dave Lovati. I think you guys might know him.
Yeah.
So Dave Lovati is also working on the sound effects, or it's called Foley. And lastly, we have Mr. Simeone Sivendrenze, who is the cultural officer at the
right.
He will be the cultural consultant for this production, which is really cool because we have someone on the side. You know, we can always refer to him and say, hey, you know, does this look Fijian enough? Is this authentic? You know, does this work out? You know, yeah.
Nice.
Okay. Victoria's got one more question to ask you. But just before that, Victoria, Meli, can I just ask you something? We actually forgot to ask one question. What is the film about? If you can, without giving away too much.
Oh, no, that's fine. So the film is, it depicts the last day of a human sacrifice in alternate reality CG. So there's going to be a ceremony where people are going to celebrate the launch of the giant canoe, the Ndrua. And because this is an alternate Fiji, this is a Fiji where Westernization didn't really take away our cultures and traditions. And so we still practice a lot of the a lot of those practices, including for the sake of this particular short film, including human sacrifices. And so this short film shows what Fiji looks like, practicing an old tradition but brought forward to modern times.
Right. And our final question for this morning is, how do we help support the Solimbula project?
So there is a budget for the short film, and the people that I just mentioned on the team, they all actually I know most of them like as friends, and so they're like, yeah, sure, I wouldn't mind working on this, but I wanted to try and get everyone paid proper, because they're all professionals in their own right.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So we put together a budget, but as it stands, I actually have no money. And so what we're trying to do is a Kickstarter fundraising. Kickstarter, for those of you who don't know, it's a website online where you can donate money towards artistic projects. And so I've put this short film project on Kickstarter. And if you want to contribute to the production, you can go to kickstarter.com. and search up Solimbula, and then that's where you can make a financial contribution. If you can't, that's fine, because times are hard. So sharing the link would be just as good. If you go to our Solimbula Facebook page, that's where you see a lot more details about other links to the Kickstarter website, as well as other details of the production.
Nice. Thank you so much for speaking to us this morning, Meli. All the best on your project and stay safe.
Thank you, Naka.